So we're asked to compare these two numbers right over here. And I just took a picture from the Khan Academy exercise, but this isn't it itself, so I can't click on this. But if you did click on it on the exercise, you'd get to choose between one of these three. But I'll just write it down. So we're going to compare 2.7 to 2 and 17 hundredths. So there's a bunch of ways you could do this. You could convert both of them to mixed numbers. So for example, 2.7, you could rewrite. This is the same thing as 2 and 7 tenths. 2 and 7 tenths. You could compare 2 and 7 tenths to this right over here, which is 2 and 17 hundredths. 2 and 17 hundredths. So they both have a 2, so you want to compare the fraction part. So what's larger, 7 tenths or 17 hundredths? Well, if it doesn't jump out at you, you could convert this to hundredths. 7 tenths is the same thing. If you want to convert it to hundredths, you could multiply the denominator by 10. Which would make the 10 into 100, and then you'd also have to multiply the numerator by 10. So 2 and 7 tenths is the same thing as 2 and 70 hundredths. And so 70 hundredths is for sure bigger than 17 hundredths. So this number, 2 and 7 tenths, or 2 and 70 hundredths, or 2.7, is going to be greater than this number. So it's going to be greater than. We open the symbol to the larger number. Another way that we could have thought about this is we could have converted them both to decimals. So we have 2.7, which we could leave as a decimal, 2.7. But then 2 and 17 hundredths we could write as 2.17. This is 17 hundredths over here. And there's a bunch of ways that you could make this comparison. You could just say, well, look, 2 and 7 tenths is the same thing as 2 and 70 hundredths. Over here I have 70 hundredths. Over here I only have 17 hundredths. So this is going to be larger. This one's going to be larger right over here. Another way you could have thought about it is, well, look, you start in the ones place. They both have 2 ones, so that doesn't tell you much. But as soon as you go to the tenths place, this number has 7 tenths, while this one only has 1 tenth. So this number right over here is going to be greater than that number. Let's do another example. Which of the following are less than 2.03, or 2 and 3 hundredths? Each big square represents one whole. So one way we could do it, and this is kind of the way that jumps out at me, is let's write all of these as decimals. So this one over here, we have one whole, another whole, and then over here I don't have a full whole. Let's see, I've taken a whole, I've divided it into tenths, and I have 2 tenths right over here. So this number right over here is equal to 2 and 2 tenths. You see that, 2, 1, 2, and then 2 of the 10 equal sections, so 2 and 2 tenths, which is the same thing as 2.2. And if we wanted to compare it to 2.03, well, we just have to think about this. Well, there's a bunch of ways you could think about this. You could view this as 2.20, which would mean this is 2 and 20 hundredths. And 2 and 20 hundredths is for sure greater than 2 and 3 hundredths. So this is not less than 2.03. This one over here is greater than 2.03. So I'm going to rule that one out. Another way you could have thought about this is 2 and 2 tenths, which is the same thing as 2 and 20 hundredths. This is another way of representing that. And you say, well, this one over the number you're comparing against is 2 and 3 hundredths. So 20 hundredths is greater than 3 hundredths. So once again, this is not less than 2.03. Here we have 2 and 12 hundredths. And actually, this is useful because I already have our original number represented as 2 and 3 hundredths. So the whole number part, the 2 is the same. So when you look at the fraction part, 12 hundredths is greater than 3 hundredths. So this one also is not less than 2.03. Now what about 23 hundredths? 23 hundredths, we could write like this, 23 hundredths. Or we could write it like this, 23 hundredths. And you might be tempted to say, oh, well, hey, 23 hundredths, that's bigger than 3 hundredths. But remember, we have 2 holes over here. We have 2 holes. We have no holes over here. We have, over here, one way to think about it, you have nothing in the ones place. Over here, you have something in the ones place. So when you look at the ones place here, you have two ones, you have zero ones over here. It doesn't matter how many hundredths you have if you have less than 100 hundredths. And so this one is for sure less than 2.03. This is significantly less than even one. So this one is the only of the three that is less than 2.03. Let's do one more of these. Order the following values from least to greatest. And once again, I took a picture from the Khan Academy exercise, so I'm not going to be able to drag them around. If you're doing the exercise, you would be able to drag them around. But I'm just going to think about the numbers and then write them in order. So I want to write them all. Let's write them all as decimals, I guess is the easiest thing to do. So here, this one's already written as a decimal, 2.59. 24 tenths. So let's think about this. That's 24 over 10. Well, 24 over 10 is the same thing. This is equal to 20 over 10 plus 4 over 10. 20 tenths, this is two holes right over here. So this is the same thing as 2 and 4 tenths. Or the same thing as 2.4, 2 and 4 tenths. Now, if we want to make a comparison to 2 and 59 hundredths, we could throw another zero right over here. And you say, okay, we could view this as 2 and 40 hundredths. So these are all different ways of representing this. Some of y'all might have been able to go immediately, hey, look, 10 tenths is 1, 20 tenths is 2, so 24 tenths is going to be 2 and 4 tenths, or 2.4, or 2.40. Now let's try this number, 2 and 3 tenths. We could represent that as 2.3. If we want to think of it in terms of hundredths, you could say, well, this is the same thing as 2 and 30 hundredths, which you could also represent as 2.30. And the reason why I'm adding the hundredths there is so we can more easily make the comparison. So you're comparing 2 and 59 hundredths to 2 and 40 hundredths to 2 and 30 hundredths. Well, they all have 2 in the ones place. They all have 2 in the ones place. So then we just have to go to the tenths place. And you see, this has the most tenths, 5 tenths. This is the second most, 4 tenths. And this has the least tenths, 3 tenths. So ordering from least to greatest, the least is 2 and 3 tenths. The least is 2 and 3 tenths, which is equal to 2.3. The next, the one larger, next larger than that, is going to be 24 tenths. 24 tenths. Which is equal to 2.4. And then the largest is 2.59. And once again, they all have 2 in the ones place. And then you go to the tenths, this has 3 tenths, 4 tenths, 5 tenths.